We've always known how we are like the trees and not like them. We walk and live more briefly.
There is something timeless about this place, and a sense that little has changed over the passing years, decades, even centuries. What life there is clings hard to the side of the mountain. That will to live has meant survival in the face of adversity.
Now you can see that in there is a white spot. That's the seed. From that grows the mighty ancient tree.
Alan Silverstein has been looking for months to find the survivor of nearly 2,500 Colorado summers, a bristlecone pine tree, the oldest tree in the state.
We are so close, I can smell it.
He's looking here at 11,000 feet on a rocky slope within a grove of the ancient ones, Pinus aristata.
Grandfather trees.
Grandfather trees.
That's what I call them, grandfather trees.
Half dead, but half alive, the grandfather trees have held their ground and their secrets for more than two millennia.
The reason they get so old is because they grow in places where most other trees won't.
The fact that it sits here and waits and waits and waits for us to visit.
Two clues brought Alan here on this warm summer day. An old photograph taken with a camera that someone abandoned nearby. And metal tags left some 20 years before by another man, perhaps even more determined than Alan, a man named Craig Brunstein.
He was a geologic map editor, but he had an abiding interest in bristlecone pines.
Craig discovered the bristlecones in 1968 when he was still in high school.
I think he liked the high country.
His love of the outdoors paved the way for a distinguished career with the U.S. Geological Survey.
Bingo, 49 inches.
But it took Craig over 20 years after he first made his discovery to come back to verify his hunch that these trees, the trees he had kept a secret, were the oldest known living trees in Colorado.
I believe that without what Craig did, I don't think the age of these particular trees would have been studied or known.
He was passionate.
Oh, there's no question he was passionate.
Solving the riddle and finding the trees became Alan's passion.
Well, there's a long and intricate detective story for how we ended up here.
Okay, so.
The abandoned camera gave up the most vital clue, a picture of the tree with the valley floor below. With a little guesswork, a chance to find Craig's tree. And now, during the 55th summer of his life, Alan is back at the place of the secret trees, hoping that this time he will find them.
And he found a total of 5 trees that are over 2,000 years old.
A gathering of friends and colleagues will increase the chances.
Gotta see this. This is way cool.
But like all things that are worth the effort, there's a price to be paid.
On a superficial level, it's just another adventure. At a deeper level, it really is touching mortality, immortality.
There it is. It's right here.
Oh, wow, that's gotta be it.
Beautiful.
Gotta be it.
It's good to finally meet this tree. What a monarch. What a monument. A living monument.
If wind were wood, it might resemble this. Fragility and strength, old bark bleeding amber.
The mystery of the state's oldest trees, first discovered, then protected by one man, rediscovered by another who understands the significance of his find.
So if you add enough superlatives, anything is special. But oldest living tree in the Rocky Mountains is not too many superlatives. It's pretty special.